In this last video, we're going to talk about how we can show groundwater movement using something called flow nets. So changes in hydraulic head are often characterized using these flow nets, and you can draw them for vertical cross sections because we know there are gradients in hydraulic head between higher and lower elevations and different points within an aquifer. So how do we do that? And we can also draw them horizontally across a landscape. So we'll deal with the vertical cross-section flow nets first. Using this little animation, which is outside of my recording area. So let me fix that. Okay, so here we have a piezometer installed. Here's the well bottom. Here's the water level. The water level is telling us what the hydraulic head is at this point at the bottom of the well. So how do we go about figuring out where the water is going in this little section of groundwater? Okay, so we know that the hydraulic head is equal to this elevation here at the bottom of the well. So let's find a point of equal hydraulic head. We'll know that that's that elevation of the water table is going to be equal to the hydraulic head at the bottom of the well. So we can draw a line connecting those two points. Okay, so then we can go ahead and put in a different well, and we find a different piezometer, I should say, and we find that hydraulic head at this point is equal to essentially the water table right there, and which we know is equal to the hydraulic head over here at this point. And we'd like to be able to connect these two points somehow. So we're going to have to put in another well, another piezometer. And we're lucky enough that we found another another point with equal hydraulic head so that we can finish connecting these lines here. Okay, so then what goes on in the rest of the landscape here? We put in another piezometer and we find out that the hydraulic head at this point way down here is equal to the hydraulic head right at the ground table, or right at the water table. So we just finished drawing that line straight down. Okay, then I put in another piezometer over here. So hydraulic head at this point is equal to this elevation. So we can draw two lines going out to points that have equal hydraulic head to this point here, and then we can connect all three of those points right there, just like that. Okay, so all of these lines are showing us sort of lines of constant hydraulic head, and those have other names. People call them isopotentials or equipotentials, but they're just lines of constant hydraulic head. So the next thing we want to do is draw what's called streamlines or flow paths, flow lines. And flow lines are drawn perpendicular to these isopotentials or lines of constant hydraulic head, moving from low to high hydraulic head. So we just draw them perpendicularly across these isopotentials, showing water movement. Okay, so that's pretty much it. But it's a lot to assimilate. So I'll show you some other examples, and we're actually going to do an example of this in class to give us a bit of break from me talking at you. Okay, so here's kind of a summary of what we just saw. These lines here are isopotentials or equipotential lines. They're just lines of constant hydraulic head, and then we draw streamlines or flow lines perpendicular to these lines of constant hydraulic head. Okay, so this is a map view. It's like an aerial photo, so we're looking down on a landscape here. And these little dots here are showing you water well locations. So in this case, we're just drawing how is water moving at the surface, sort of. Where is the water table going, and where is the groundwater beneath that going? So these are just monitoring wells, essentially, and this shows you the height of the water in all of those wells, which is equal to the hydraulic head. So the first thing that you would do if you were looking at this map is try to figure out, okay, say I'm going to draw a line for 260 for the elevation of the water, of the elevation of groundwater, so maybe that would go right through here. And you would do that for consistent intervals, so maybe you do it for 260, and then for 250 through here, and 240, and so on. So that might end up looking something like this. So that's sketching the isopotentials in the lines of constant hydraulic head. And then you would go ahead and add in the flow lines, moving again from high hydraulic head up here down to low hydraulic head, but you want to make sure that you're crossing these isopotentials at roughly 90 degree angles perpendicularly. Okay, so when you draw these streamlines or flow lines, you want to make sure you're drawing them perpendicularly to isopotentials and or any body of water in the landscape. So perpendicularly to isopotentials and rivers and lakes, which is essentially what this is summing up for you. So flow net drawing rules, first you sketch out the isopotentials using information either from piezometers, if you're doing a vertical profile, or from monitoring wells and water table height, if you're doing a map view flow net. And then draw in the streamlines to indicate flow direction, moving from high to low hydraulic head. And these streamlines are always perpendicular to isopotentials and to rivers and lakes. Rivers and lakes have constant hydraulic head, so you're essentially just you're drawing these flow lines perpendicular to any line of constant hydraulic head. And then they move parallel, perhaps unsurprisingly, to impermeable boundaries. So if you've got a water table, or if you've got an aquifer bounded on either side by rock canyon walls, say, the water is going to move parallel to those rock canyon walls. Okay, so that's pretty much it. So flow nets are just a way to show water lines of constant hydraulic head and the flow of that water. And that's it. And the next thing we'll talk about in class after we do a little bit of talking about groundwater pollution and then drawing some flow nets is how do we know how fast groundwater moves? And again, thanks for watching. Whoops.